Tottenham fans getting in touch. What do you know? What do we know? When are you going to announce this, that Conte has pitched up at Tottenham and he is the man for the job? What we do know is that Antonio Conte and his representatives remain in advanced talks with Tottenham to become the new manager. So this has come a bit left field, but by God, when it exploded yesterday, what an impact it had, what a reaction it got. To me, Simon, all right, Conte, in there, and that itself is a headline story.
Yep.
But the very fact that Tottenham have also, that Levy has made an offer to the former Juventus director Fabio Paratici to become the new director of football, yep, tells me, by God, Tottenham are serious about this.
I think, honestly, if people that know Tottenham Hotspur inside and out, not just the fans, but people that have been in that framework, know that Daniel needs to devolve power and needs to leave certain aspects of the football operation to the football people and concentrate on running the financial side of Tottenham Hotspur and making sure that the stadium funding and the facilitation of finances and all the stuff that Daniel does brilliantly and the deal making on individual transactions are done by Daniel, but devolve the power to the football operation. Now, Conte, yes, coming in, if he's bringing this director of football in, those are two statements that are very, very big statements, because it tells you, I said yesterday, I can see either which way. I can see one end of the spectrum or I can see the other, nothing in the middle, which is you either get someone with less of a reputation like a Graham Potter that has all the potential to be successful but not yet the track record, or you get a superstar in football terms. And Conte falls into the superstar category. And it doesn't surprise me if Tottenham do this deal, because A, Tottenham fans should be massively encouraged, because Conte doesn't suffer fools gladly.
No.
I don't always like his style of operation, and I think he can be a difficult, divisive character. But you find me a top football manager that probably isn't, and you know, and I'll tell you that actually they're not a top football manager.
Actually, I think Conte is a lot more dignified as well than a lot of people give him credit for, because he's looked upon as this explosive madcap type on the touchline, ready to rock at any time. You remember at Stamford Bridge, when Chelsea did a job, yeah, on United, yeah, and Mourinho went the front foot, whispering in his Conte's ear. Conte just gave it, whatever.
But Mourinho did that because he felt Conte was playing to the gallery.
Why not?
Well, because perhaps between managers they think there's an element of decorum. Go back and look at Conte's career. Look at him at Atalanta and how the fans got very angry with him at certain times because of his disposition. Look, in order to be a leader, and a football manager is a leader inside the football framework, you're going to be somewhat difficult at times because all you're focused on is what you want. You couldn't care less about the consequences of what it is that what you're asking someone to provide for you. If you go and get Conte as Tottenham Hotspur, you're saying something quite significant. The fact he'll come to Tottenham Hotspur is actually more significant, because Conte's not coming for nothing. He's not coming because he wants to be part of the project. He's not coming because he wants to get a big bag of money, because he can get that in most places.
For sure.
He's coming because he's ready to go.
Yes.
And Tottenham, that means Tottenham are in business mode. And that means, I suspect, that Tottenham are going to have a go. Because Daniel needs to. He's got his bloody big stadium and all of his marketing activity. And his advertising is great, but his product ain't so dandy.
Would you put Tottenham amongst the favourites to win the Premier League title if Conte goes there?
God, no. Why? What, on what basis? They've got to overhaul their squad. They've got to replenish.
Look at what he's just done at Inter.
Yeah, I know. But comparing Inter and the Serie A to the current condition of Manchester City and perhaps a rebooted Liverpool.
Yeah, but Simon, look at what he revitalised Christian Eriksen. Eriksen leaves Tottenham and people were saying, oh, we're glad to see him go. He wasn't doing it. He goes over there, Conte made him a better player immediately.
That's not a fair comparison, because Eriksen wanted to get out the door, and Eriksen was
look at what he did with Lukaku. Agitating. Ashley Young loves him.
Yeah, but Lukaku was doing great things in England. Just because he had a bit of a time at Man United where it didn't go the way he wanted. Still look at his goal scoring record at Man United, by the way. Look at his goal scoring record at Everton. You know, this is a player that scores goals. He felt unloved by Mourinho at Man United. He went to Inter Milan. He's not been that challenged there. He had a few challenges in Italy. But they're good players. You know, he did the same thing with Diego Costa. Got him on the front foot. Yeah, fell out with Costa spectacularly, right, at the end of their particular period, because Costa was agitating to leave to go to China when they were trying to win the Premier League.
Oh, sure, yes. But I see what you're saying, but
I think it says more about where Tottenham really are trying to go, that if they can get Conte across the line with the dough that he's going to cost them, and it blows my brains at what some of these managers are getting, you know, but that's a different discussion. If they're going to get him in the door, it must tell Tottenham fans, this is go mode for Tottenham now again.
But Daniel Levy has had a change of tack, if you like, as well, because all of a sudden he's willing to delegate. The reputation that Levy has, and you know him, I know him as well, is that he does the lot. He's hands-on, it's his club, he runs it the way he wants. The significant aspect of this is that in comes, if he comes in, Conte, with this guy, the former Juventus director of football, Paratici. Yeah. So Paratici isn't there to make up the numbers. He'll be his own man.
He's had other people in that position, didn't he? Hasn't had Damien Camoli there as well?
But it's a significant change, Simon.
Yeah, no. It's basically a thinking process from Daniel, probably going, priority. My priority is to hold together the economics of Tottenham Hotspur in order for the core product to prosper. Okay, let me deal with the core, with this over here, and let me put the football people in place and go, bang, okay. I accept the fact that things aren't going the way I want them to go. Let's change the direction of travel. Daniel is as smart as paint. He may not be the greatest communicator. He may be an accountant at heart, which doesn't make him the most charismatic company. But what he is he's, drilled down.
Yeah.
He's drilled down and focused. And I think this sends out, if they get it across the line, this sends out a really big statement. Because I cannot imagine why Conte's going to Tottenham unless he's got absolute surety that he's going to be backed.
Yes.
So if that's the case, because otherwise, what's he going there for? What's he going to Tottenham for? He's just won Serie A. He probably could have an embarrassment of riches of clubs that can come up. Why Tottenham? Because Tottenham must be whispering in his ear something he likes to hear.
Well, Spurs Andrew is saying, listen, guys, Conte, he's got an incredible record when it comes to turning declining teams around. He took over 7th place Juventus, won Serie A, took over 10th place Chelsea and won the Premier League, took over 4th place Inter Milan in 2019 and won Serie A. Spurs Andrew, you're not wrong with that. These are great stats. Interestingly, Simon, Paratici, and I'm keen to find out more about this character, he was a fairly indifferent player. He was here, there, and everywhere in Italy when he played. Pavia, Sassuolo, Novara, Palermo, Brindisi. They are not movers and shakers in Italian football. But at least he played at a reasonable level.
But look at the analysis of Conte as a player. He played with people like Roberto Bettiger and people of that quality.
Oh, sure.
And the fact that he's a good coach, Baggio. Yeah. And he talks about the fact that because he played as a midfield player, he can understand both the dynamics of forward play and the dynamics of defensive play. That's why he sets up with a 3-5-2 mentality. He's a proper coach.
You're one of the few that actually qualified to answer this from Tony. Is it the case, though, maybe this isn't Levy's decision? This is Lewis. Lewis is having Joe Lewis, the man at the very top, having a change of heart.
No.
Go in this direction.
No. Daniel will be, it may be in consultation with Joe, but Daniel will be making the decisions. Daniel will be advocating for the change of direction or the continuation. It is actually a continuation. Mourinho, proven winner. Bring him in, couldn't get on with him, didn't do the job.
Yeah.
Conte, proven current winner, bring him in, continue the trend of an upward movement into high-profile managers. Pochettino was not a high-profile manager. Neither was Wanda Ramos. Neither, with respect to Harry Redknapp, was Harry Redknapp. Well-known, but not high-profile in terms of achievements. Tottenham's focus is changing. Okay, sod this lark for taking in managers that we can learn with and that can build with us and that can change the direction of the club. Let's get some proven winners in. Mourinho, nah, didn't work out, but I've cut my teeth on that. Now I'll get a guy that's current. I know they can be difficult, and I tell you what, I can't be dealing with the difficulty of it. I don't want that all or nothing nonsense where I'm looking like I'm batting my eyes at a manager. I'll get a director of football in. He can deal with that rubbish.
Got you.
That's what I think is going on.
So, Tottenham fans, what does it tell us? Does this show, Simon says, that Tottenham seriously mean business? Is this a massive change in direction, but one that you welcome? Conte to Tottenham. It's much further down the line this morning than it was yesterday, so we are now waiting to find out when this announcement might be made.
Jim White and Simon Jordan. Monday to Thursday morning, 10 till 1. On AM, on DAB, via the talkSPORT app and on your smart speaker. talkSPORT.